Some people hear their own inner voices with great clearness, and they live by what they hear. Such people become crazy. They become legend. Tristan Ludlow was born in the moon of the falling leaves. It was a terrible winter. His mother almost died bringing him into this world. His father, the colonel, brought him to me, and I wrapped him in a bearskin and held him all that night. As he grew into a man, I taught him the great joy of the kill. When the hunter cuts out its warm heart, holds it in his hands, setting its spirit free. Colonel Ludlow had three sons, but Tristan was his favorite. I had had sons too, but they were gone now, forever. It was a very bad time. The colonel had tried to help the people. It was no use, so he decided to go his own way. He wanted to lose the madness over the mountains, he said, and begin again. Lose the madness, he said, and so we lived for many years. Boys grew strong. Alfred was the older brother, old even for his years. Samuel was the youngest. There was nothing these brothers would not do for him. They watched over him like a treasure. One year, but it was the moon of the red grass when Isabel Ludlow, their mother, went away for the winter. She said the winters were too cruel for her. She said she was afraid of the bears. She was a strange woman anyway. That spring, though, she did not return. And after that, she did not come much to see us. Alfred wrote her many letters, but Tristan refused to speak of her. His world was here with me. Every warrior hopes a good death will find him, but Tristan couldn't wait. He went looking for his. Thank you.
What? Was it a bear?
Yes, sir.
Can you breathe?
Yes.
Take your hand away. Come on, take it away. Oh, boy. You're a stupid half-brained jackass. Did you know that?
Yes, sir.
One step put you up to this? He deserves to be dead, you know that? God knows how you've lived so long. It'll be all right, son.
Hijo, sagite taba. Yeah. Tomo sonto. Skook a mad scene over here, cooking our aims. Tomo sonde, what?
I have these letters, many letters. Read them. They are from all of them. Ludlow, Isabel, Samuel, the whole family, the whole story. It is all written here.
April the 13th, 1913. Dear Isabel, I am not fool enough to try to reorder a life already lived. But I fear I have not done well raising our sons alone in this wild place. What did I know of children? I was trained to lead men. This is infinitely harder.
Dear William, you take too much responsibility on yourself, as always. Our sons are finding their own paths. They are willful, certainly. But then, who are you and I to complain of willfulness? As for Samuel, I have big news. At a Harvard tea for Amy Lowell, he met and instantly loved Miss Susanna Fingannon. And William, I know it will surprise you greatly, but they are engaged. He will bring her to Montana this summer to introduce her to his brothers and to you. So, William, please behave yourself and be as charming as only you can be.
Fiance, Susanna.
Hello.
Miss Fingannon.
Oh, nice to meet you.
It's an honor.
And this is Alfred.
Hello.
How do you do?
Here's your dog, miss.
Thank you.
It's a horse.
That's a strange looking animal.
This is Finn. He's a champion, aren't you, Finn?
You like exotic looking dogs then, Miss Fingannon?
Very much, Mr. Ludlow. Please call me Susanna.
All right.
And he's just plain old Alfred.
You shut up.
Where's Tristan?
He's off somewhere. You know him.
Well, he'll be here tonight to welcome his brother home, or I don't know the reason why. Well, Miss Fingannon, please, you have a good journey.
She is such a lovely creature, William. But I fear the loss of her parents has given her a certain fragility. And at times I think she feels very alone in the world. But she has found a new family now, hasn't she?
And the German military is ready to use chaos in Croatia as a justification for actions that could just plunge the entire civilized world into
action. Samuel, word civilized has no place in any discussion of the affairs of this world.
Miss Fingannon, Mother has told us of your sympathy for the social reformers.
You make it sound like a disease.
No. On the contrary, I'm in agreement.
Well, your mother has told me all about one staff. She says that he was a great warrior.
Oh, yes. He has a bag of scalps hidden away somewhere to prove it, too. But don't worry. He's devoted to father now. Or rather, they're devoted to each other.
Can he speak English?
Staff? Speak English? He wouldn't lower himself to speak English, would you, Stab?
Oh,
watch out, because he understands it perfectly well.
Hey, there's Tristan.